Hello children, I am your English teacher Sujata. Hope all of you are fine and safe at home. This is your new English Broadway literature book and today we are going to start our first lesson. The name of the lesson is The Shell Falls Apart, written by Chinua Achebe. Yes, it is pronounced as Chinua Achebe. Let us start the lesson with author's introduction. Look at this picture. He is the author of the lesson. He was born in Nigeria, which is in the second largest continent, that is Africa. Chinua Achebe was a novelist, a poet, a professor, and a critic. You know, a novelist is a person who writes novels. A poet is the one who writes poems. A professor is a person who teaches in a college. And what is a critic? A critic is a person who expresses his opinions on various matters like films, books, and even music. Chinua Achebe's first novel was Things Fall Apart, which was published in the year 1858. He was born on 16th November 1930. He studied in the University of London, University of Ibadan, and Government College, Imahuya. Some of his books are Arrow of God, No Longer at Ease, A Man of the People, The Trouble with Nigeria, and An Image of Africa. He has won many awards and honors like Freedom's Prize, D. Deutschen Buchhandels in 2002, International Booker Prize in 2007, the Dorothy and Lillian Gish Prize in 2010, and St. Louis Literary Award in 1999. He died on 24th March 2013 at the age of 82 in Boston in USA. The Shell Falls Apart. Children, first I'll read the paragraph line by line, then give you the meanings of new words, and then I'll explain the paragraph in simple English. Let me read the paragraph. The Shell Falls Apart. This is an excerpt from the novel Things Fall Apart by Chinua Achebe. It opens with a description of a typical evening scene in Okonkwo's compound. The day's work is done and his wife Ekwifi is sharing songs and stories with the children. She narrates to her daughter Ezinma the delightful legend of the tortoise and the birds. We can see only hope that such folk stories will be preserved and will not be forgotten as the Igbo villages gradually become part of a new and different world. Let me give the meanings of new words. Here, excerpt means a short piece from a writing or a book. A big book will be written by an author. And from that big book, a small part is taken and read as a lesson. Narrates means tells. Legend is a traditional story from the past. Maybe it is true or not. Let me explain it. Here, the lesson Shell Falls Apart is taken from the book written by Chinua Achebe, Things Fall Apart. Here in this lesson, there is a scene of evening in Okonkwo's compound. Okonkwo is an Igbo leader and wrestling champion. All the day's work is finished and Okonkwo's wife is sitting with her children sharing songs and stories. And she is narrating her daughter, whose name is Ezinma, a delightful legend, means a true or not true story of tortoise birds. And all the stories of this world are preserved and not forgotten because all the villagers are turning into a new and different world. Let us start the story. The night was impenetrably dark. The moon had been rising later and later every night. Until now, it was seen only at dawn. and whenever the moon rose at cockcrow, the nights were as black as charcoal. Ezinma and her mother sat on a mat on the floor after their supper of yam fufu and bitter leaf soup. A palm oil lamp gave out yellowish light. Without it, it would have been impossible to eat. One could not have known where one's mouth was in the darkness of that night. There was an oil lamp in all the four huts on Okonkwo's compound, and each hut, seen from the others, looked like a soft eye of yellow half-light set in the solid massiveness of night. Now, the meanings. First, impenetrably dark means the night was so dark that nothing could be seen in that night. Then, cockcrow, early in the morning, when it is becoming light. As you know that, when in villages, with the cockcrow, all the villagers, when it says cock-a-doodle-doo, all the villagers will get up. That is, it is the daybreak. The moon has gone and the sun has come. Then charcoal, a black form of wood, when it is heated without air. Then yam fufu is a vegetable like potato and it is cooked as a dish. Massiveness is very huge. When the moon doesn't set up early, the nights will be longer. Here it is described as massive. So here is the explanation. The night was very dark, means nothing, no, all the people cannot see anything in that darkness. And the moon was rising later and later every night, means the nights are becoming longer and longer. After some time, the moon was seen only at dawn, means early morning. And when the moon came up at the cock crow, means when the cock said cock-a-doodle-doo, all the night was gone and it was like charcoal black. Ezinma and her mother were sitting on the floor after their dinner of a dish prepared by a potato-like vegetable called fufu and a soup made from a bitter leaf. Because the night was very dark, they were using a palm oil lamp which was giving yellow light. Not like our tube light which will give white light. Our bulb will be there that give yellowish light. Here the palm oil lamp was also giving yellowish light. Without that lamp, no one was able to eat because as the night was very dark, one would have not known where one's mouth was. So the oil lamp was their only source of light. As you know that there was four huts in the compound and all the huts were having one palm oil lamp. And when the hut was seen from the other hut, it was looking like half light set in the large night, dark night. Next paragraph. The world was silent except for the shrill cry of insects, which was part of the night, and the sound of wooden mortar and pestle by Nuwaki pounded her fufu. Nuwaki lived four compounds away and she was notorious for her late cooking. Every woman in the neighborhood knew the sound of Nuwaki's mortar and pestle. It was also the part of the night. Okonkwo had eaten and was now reclining with his back against the wall. Low voices, broken now and again by singing, reached Okonkwo from the huts as women and children told folk stories. Ekwifi and her daughter Ezinma sat on the mat on the floor. It was Ekwifi's turn to tell a story. Once upon a time, she began, all the birds were invited to a feast in the sky. They were happy and began to prepare themselves for the great day. They painted their bodies with red camwood and drew beautiful patterns on them with uli. Now the meanings. Shrill cry means loud sound made by insects. You can listen to them when it is night. Mortar is a small hard bowl which is used for grinding things. Pestle is a heavy metal or wooden rod used to grind the grains or anything in the
mortar. Pounded means grinded. Then notorious is well known for doing something bad. Sometimes you also will be behaving like notorious persons. Red camwood, African red sandalwood powder, and woolly is a brush. Now, all the world was silent as it was night and nobody will be roaming around the streets. All the world was silent, but one can hear the loud cry of insects. And it has been the part of the night. Every night they used to hear this cry of insects. And one more sound was there, that is Nuaiki, name of a woman in that compound. She used to cook her food very late. So every day after everyone has finished their dinner and sat for songs, this lady used to pound her fufu. And this has also become a everyday work for all the people in that area to listen to the sound of this mortar and pestle of Nuaiki. Then this in the Okonkwo, his wife has served him food, he has eaten, and after eating he is reclining, means leaning to the wall. Whenever you are sitting on the floor, you like to lean to something so that you give support to your backbone. This man also was reclining to the wall to give some support to his back. And you know that there were so many huts near his hut, and he was able to hear some voices broken now and again. Some people were singing, some people were telling stories to their children. And this his wife Equifi and daughter Ezinma also sat on a mat on the floor. And today it was the mother Equifi's turn to tell a story. The child was asking her mother to tell a story, so the mother started to tell a story. As you know that every mother will start the story with the words "once upon a time." So even here the Equifi started to tell "once upon a time." Then she started telling about the story. All the birds of the world were invited to a feast, means party, which was to be held in the sky. When somebody invites you for a party, you will be very happy. Same like that, the birds were also very happy that they were invited for a party in the sky. So they started to prepare themselves for the great day, that is the party. What all the preparations they have done? They have painted their bodies with red camwood. Even to any party, these birds also started to make up. Then they drew beautiful patterns on their bodies with the brush, that is called uli. So the birds started to prepare themselves for going to the party. What happened next? We'll see. Tortoise saw all these preparations and soon discovered what it all meant. Nothing had happened in the world of animals ever escaped his notice. He was full of cunning. As soon as he heard of the great feast in the sky, his throat began to itch at every thought. There was famine in those days, and the tortoise has not eaten a good meal for 2 moons. His body rattled like a piece of dry stick in his empty shell. So he began to plan how he would go to the sky. Then all these things a tortoise was looking at. Who were invited to the party? Only the birds were invited to the party. The tortoise, who was very cunning, was looking at all these preparations made by the birds. What all the preparations birds were doing? Painting their bodies and making patterns with brush. And everything, the tortoise used to observe everything, whatever is happening in the world of animals, as he was very cunning. So he came to know that there is a party to be going in the sky, and looking at the word party, his throat started to itch every thought, means when you think about delicious food, how do you feel in the mouth? You will feel that saliva is coming out. You want to eat that. The same thing was happening with the tortoise. And there was a famine, means there was a lack of food in those days. No food was there. And this tortoise has not eaten a good meal from 2 days. 2 moons means 2 days. So, when you are hungry, what kind of sounds your stomach will make? The same kind of thing was happening with the tortoise. He was rattling. Some sound was coming from the tortoise shell. Now, what to do? I have not eaten for 2 days. And there is a party in the sky. Now, the tortoise started to plan. How should I go to the sky? Next. But he had no wings, said Azinma. The girl interrupted her mother in the middle. She said, how can a tortoise go to the sky? The tortoise doesn't have wings. Be patient, replied her mother. This is a story. Tortoise had no wings, but he went to the birds and asked to be allowed to go with them. This is a story, my child. Be patient. I'll tell you the story. The tortoise, as you know, is very clever. He went to the birds and asked, you also allow me to come with you. We know you too well, said the birds when they heard him. Then the bird said that, we know how you are. Then next, you are full of cunning and you are ungrateful. If we allow you to come with us, you will soon begin your mischief. Then the birds tell that, we all know that how cunning and ungrateful, unthankful you are. If we allow you to come with us, you will start your naughty things again. Then the tortoise told, you don't know me, said tortoise. I am a changed man. I have learned that a man who makes trouble for others is also making it for himself. The tortoise started speaking cunningly to the birds. He started telling that, no, I have changed now. Now I learnt that if I make trouble for others, I will also be in trouble. So please take me with you. Tortoise had a sweet tongue, and within a short time, all the birds agreed that he has a changed man, and they each gave him a feather with which he made 2 wings. Then after speaking all the sweet things, nice words he has spoken with all the birds, and the birds after some time agreed that, okay, this tortoise has changed now, we'll give him a feather and he will come with us to the party. And all of them gave one feather to the tortoise, and with all the feathers he made 2 wings. At last the great day came, and tortoise was the first to arrive at the meeting place. When all the birds had gathered together, they set off in a body. The tortoise was very happy and voluble as he flew among the birds, and he was soon chosen as the man to speak for the party because he was a great orator. Then he made 2 wings, and at last the day came when all the birds were going to the party. First of all the tortoise came where the meeting place was there, where the birds have arranged to meet at one place before going to the party. The tortoise came there first. Then all the birds came and they are set off as a group. Set off in a body means in a group they started going to the sky for the party. And this tortoise was very happy and he was loud in speaking. He was able to speak fluently and loudly among all the birds. So soon all the birds choose tortoise to speak for the party, means for the gathering. Whenever you go to someone, they'll greet you. You also should tell them something in the mid. So these birds chose the tortoise as their speaker. Orator means the speaker who can speak fluently and clearly without making any mistakes. Children, here we'll stop, and the part 2 will continue the next part of the lesson. Thank you, children. Keep learning.